Hey everyone, and welcome to today's session about reefer containers. I've got like maybe before we start, we'll introduce ourselves. I'm not sure if we've already been in touch, probably via email. But I work at a Container Exchange, and I'm responsible for communications. And today I've got Alex with me from Conway's Container Solutions. Maybe Alex, you can introduce yourself a little bit so the people know like who you are and what you do.
Hello guys. I'm the owner of the Conway Container Solutions. We are doing the one way all over the world. Mainly markets are Baltic, Russia. We are doing also the container sales, including the reefers. So that's why I think this webinar will be quite interested for the guys who is also dealing with the trading. Should be
Yes.
useful.
Yes, and for your information, Alex reached out to us 4 to 6 weeks ago that it might make sense to host a webinar about reefer containers together because he was super interested in collecting knowledge actually and providing or recording sessions to make them available for everyone. So this is our first session together, and we are of course excited about your feedback, and we hope you enjoy the session.
Definitely. If you don't find Florian, I will just add that, guys, please, don't be close. Try to be as much open as possible, because we plan to add some new things in the future. So the main figures you would like, we will add, and we will go deeper and deeper and deeper. So just give us a feedback. Thanks.
Yep.
Okay.
Yes, and I think the session, depending on how many questions we get in the end, will take or last between 20 or 30 minutes. You can always use the chat window to ask questions. I'm not sure if you can use the microphone. We can just test it if you want. I'm recording the session now, so I will send you the recording afterwards, and also the slides as a PDF document. So. Because some slides contain a lot of text, so you can read those slides afterwards. I'll start with a very, very, very short overview of Container Exchange and Conway's, and then we'll go ahead with how reefer containers actually work. We'll give you a market overview and talk a little bit about the main players in the reefer market. We'll continue with stuffing and storage principles, and now go ahead with temperature control, atmosphere control, and talk about future marketing, not marketing, but market development as well. And we'll be there for questions and answers in the end. You probably already heard about us, Exchange. That's why you signed up for this webinar. We operate the world's first online platform in container logistics, where we connect supply and demand, and also help you find or supply reefer containers, of course. But let's don't talk too much about what we do. Maybe you can continue a little bit, Alex, and tell our attendees a little bit about Conway's.
As I told, we are doing the trading. We also do the hinterland logistics, like trucking, pre-carriage, on-carriage, all over the Benelux and Europe itself. We are based in Riga, in Latvia. We are doing the one way, not only for the dry containers, only for also for the reefers. Doing movements from Europe to Russia, from Russia to China, from China to Europe. So the reefers as one of our main products. We would like to go deeper, to get some knowledges, and to share it with you. So that's it, actually.
Yep. Cool. Thank you very much. And I think we're super excited to get your feedback, as we already said. So if you've got questions, share them with us. Let's jump right into it. This is how reefer containers look like. What is the definition? I somewhere read that's basically just a huge fridge, and this is what reefer containers are. They are designed for the transport of temperature-sensitive cargo, such as fish, vegetable, dairy, and of course come in different sizes and with different technology. Maybe it's important to mention that reefers are not designed to cool your cargo down to a specific temperature, but to hold a specific temperature instead. So if your cargo has, I don't know, 0 degrees Celsius, reefer containers are designed to keep that 0 degrees for the whole journey or transport. Let's go a little bit more into how reefers work and how the setup is. You can already see the cooling or refrigeration section of a reefer container and how the ventilator looks like. Now we'll pretty much skip the next slides because they give you deeper knowledge on condensators, for example, and this will be boring for the webinar, but we'll give you provide you with knowledge afterwards. But what is important to mention is that the temperature range for most reefers is between minus 30 degrees Celsius and plus 30 degrees Celsius. There are reefers that can go beyond that temperature range. But pretty much all of them are at least in between minus 30 and 30 degrees Celsius. And they use a special, maybe that's super significant for reefers, that they use the special T-bar floors, which we will cover within the next slides, that ensure the optimal airflow to cool down temperature. Maybe do you have something to add here, Alex? Because you said something.
Yeah. I just want to add that we also had the reefer from a Thermo King 20 feet who was freeze above this limit. It was minus 35 degrees. So there is kind of different types, and there is a lot of new things are going on the reefers. So yeah, that can be just an additional one. But in the base, that are the base temperature periods.
Maybe one more question. And what is the highest or lowest temperature you can get with the reefer container? Are there already reefer containers that can go to minus 50 or minus 60 degrees?
I'm not sure. No, actually, I'm not sure. I don't think about it because we had, and I spoke with a technical guy from the reefers, and he told us minus 35 is the lowest temperature possible. So
All right.
it's already special.
Okay. And we already talked about those T-bars a little bit, but but reefer containers in general use bottom air delivery. So it's super important that cold air can flow not only around the cargo, but also underneath the cargo and above the cargo. So reefers are built and designed with those T-bars, which you can see on the bottom of the reefer container and on the left side of the slide, that ensure that the cargo actually can flow through those T-bars and cool the cargo, or like actually maintain the temperature also from the bottom. This is probably
So
most.
it's basically cooling the cargo by the airflow.
Yes,
Wow.
yes.
Oh, okay.
This is a basic diagram or graphics that shows you every single part of the refrigeration unit. And I might start. I think it makes sense to skip most of those slides, to be honest, because it makes no sense to
Yeah.
go really deep into
Too
the compressor
specific,
section,
yeah.
for example. But if you're interested in that, just read those slides afterwards and ask as many questions as possible. So we've got a compressor section, of course. We've got condensation, evaporation, and of course fresh air ventilators, which you can see like right in the middle of the screen. That ensure that like fresh air it is possible for fresh air to go into the container. What is important to know is that reefer containers make sure to maintain the same temperature not only for the sea transport, but also, of course, if you truck your container to wherever your client is or wherever your client wants his fruits to be delivered. So reefers have a specific genset or generator that makes sure that that works. Sorry, that works on with fuel or electrical power and is used for truck transport. So they can attach such a genset when they move a reefer container via truck. And maybe you can help me out with this slide a little bit, Alex, because one of the most common problems for reefer containers comes with leakage.
So actually, before that, I want to also to ask you guys and the guys who will see the record. So think about if you would be interested in to know what kind of reefers are in the reefers, what kind of common problems are. So that might be interesting. The guys the problems in the condensate, and there is a lot of life hacks how you can actually check that. So afterwards you can just slightly go run through the text which we provided for you. I think I will not be so specific about those four things, but I would say that there is a possibility to check the water test by the soap. There is some things which you can check by the lamp, by the errors which is showing you the system, the computer from the backside of the container. And of course there is also a detector, the many errors which needable to check for the report.
Thank you very much. I saw that Michael was typing. Not sure if you've got a question, Michael. Anyways, we'll just go to the next slide, and you type in your question whenever you want. Let's continue to talk about storage and stuffing principles a little bit. Most important part. Is that there needs to be space between between your cargo and the reefer container so that the air can circulate around your cargo. Usually you can see a black line in this graphics on top of the wall. So you this is pretty much the range where you can put your cargo into. So your boxes are not should not extend beyond those lines. And yeah, I think it's pretty safe. It's super simple. So I give you just another 10 or 15 seconds to look at those slides. But I'm not sure if that's actually your interest. To know how to stuff or storage your cargoes. So we'll see.
Michael, we will definitely provide you the refrigerant gases. What are the main gases are? Afterwards, I will send you the table with the link about those gases. It's
Perfect.
quite actually, interesting question.
Perfect. So two of the most important function of reefer containers are temperature control and atmosphere control. And we start with temperature control in the beginning. There's two of them actually. I'll go to the next slide. There's temperature control for frozen products and temperature control for chilled products. And there's a huge and important difference in between. For chilled products, it is super important, as you can see with those blue arrows in the infographics, to leave enough space in between your cargo so that there's a good ch sorry, give me 1 second. The temperature needs to be circulated not even around, not only around the cargo, but also through out the entire load. Because if you think about meat, for example, or many other products that produce gases, for example, when it has a higher temperature, and reefers need to make sure to remove those gases from in between the cargo. That's super important. But there's also a frozen mode, where it's first of all important to mention that reefers are not designed to lower down the temperature of your cargo, but to maintain that temperature. So if you've got ice cream, for example, or fries, like it is on this infographics, there's no heat or warm temperature that needs to be removed from inside or from in between the cargo, because there's no heat coming from frozen fries. So you can move them or put them together, and it's only important to have a barrier for warmer temperature from outside of the reefer container. So you need to ensure that there is air circulating around your cargo. But that's the biggest difference between frozen products and chilled products, that you need no space in between your cargo, as you can see in this case. One good example for frozen products would be ice cream or fries. For chilled products, it could be meat, also fruits, and completely depending on your customers, of course, and what they export or import. Next slide will be about atmosphere control. So it's not only important to regulate the temperature, but it's also important sorry guys, to control the atmosphere and the level of humidity in your container. Atmosphere control has two main functions. One is fresh air ventilation, and the second is humidity control. Fresh air, you can see the fresh air ventilation on the right side on this small picture, and that ensures that there's always the right amount of fresh air inside the container to avoid cargo damage, such as uncontrolled ripening, for example, or aging. Especially when you talk about fruits or vegetables like bananas, for example, because they already take the time of the transport into consideration when they put bananas, for example, into a reefer container to make sure when they export them from, I don't know, Southern America to Europe, for example, that they are fresh when they arrive in Europe so that we can buy them in the supermarket. So that would be fresh air ventilation, and humidity control is goes pretty much into the same direction and makes sure that the amount of water and humidity is exactly as designed in the beginning to make sure to not damage any cargo, and to make sure that as we can see in the next slide. Yes, here, that the amount of ethylene, for example, or CO2 and carbon dioxide is exactly right in every reefer container. And how do they do that? Not sure, Alex, maybe you can help me out in this case. I'm not, but I think every reefer container has data loggers, so they can automatically set a specific amount of every component, so the data loggers can monitor supply air temperature and the return air to make sure that we have the right amount of ethylene or water or
Everything can be installed from the humidity, the level of the humidity, the temperature, and everything can be easily controlled.
Perfect. I think maybe just give you another second to go through that last slide about atmosphere control. Any questions so far from any of the attendees? If not, I would just go ahead and maybe that's designed for you, Alex, as well, because of course there is a pre-trip inspection to ensure that your reefer is in good condition for transport. Maybe you can give us one or two examples or tell you about your experience.
I think everybody knows about the PCI test, so it should be in a good shape. You need to have the inspector to come along to your container before you can release it to the carrier for the next use. Actually, as I know, they are testing the equipment to the run mode for 30, 40 minutes maximum. And yeah, if there is no errors, if the system, the computer showing that the level is not dropping down or up, everybody works and the CI test that.
So
So
just
it's but yeah, so it's only by the rough words from my side.
No,
There is,
but there's two parts of the reefer pre-trip inspection. There's one with power off and one with power on. Yes, to ensure that everything works perfectly fine. Yet no, maybe yes, there are different reefers, and there's probably like. When I did my first research about reefer containers, there's of course like many different technical specifications and many different models, of course. But mainly there's like four different players that regulate the reefer market on a global scale, with some smaller regional reefer experts, of course. But the main players in the reefer market are Transicold, Maersk, Daikin, and Thermo King. And it does, like, as I said in the beginning, reefer containers are pretty much like just like big fridges that are that with a function to maintain a certain temperature. So there are minor differentiations that like those companies do not produce the same reefers, of course, but they have no like huge differences in between, so it's pretty much just a question of what brand you trust or a question of availability, what reefer container you should buy. I'm not sure if you want to add something here, Ali.
It depends on the market and on the customer needs, of course. Because, for example, in Russia, mostly use the carrier equipment and the Thermo King. Daikin, not much. So that depends on the customer. And the guys, if you want to know more about some of the specific names or something, let us know afterwards.
Yeah, just wait for Kiedrius, who is typing at the moment, and maybe we've got a question here. Before we go on.
Actually, it might be interesting, to analyze which supplier mostly in which country is popular, some kind of thing.
So how do you decide between those four options, Alex?
Mostly, let's say the general, the easy way always to buy carrier because it's very popular. It's not having so that much problems. I mean, by system itself, by the computer, by the PC. Thermo King as well. I heard, I'm not specialist in it, but I heard Daikin have much more errors and problems if you will compare with a thermoking or carrier.
Okay, so that's but it's your personal experience and your
That's my personal business experience, I would say. Yes, of course.
Okay, so I cannot see anyone typing anymore, so I guess
The show already typed it in.
can you see it? Ah, there,
Yeah.
yeah. Maybe like I cannot answer this question to be honest. I would
And need some time, to prepare because do you refer the term? I think it's need to check, of course, deeper how to answer that, how to
yeah.
get
I think
the research to
like
the veterinarian.
it's a tough question because there's different laws like for every country. I think there's no like go-to rule or no like not like one strategy that you have to follow, but it's different for every country. Not sure. But we will.
Might be, definitely might be, because there is
Okay.
also the inspections
Yes.
for kind of for the EU in general.
Thank you very
There is
much.
definitely requirements and the certificates which every reefer before loading they are checking what kind of product unit you would like to load, where to export, when it's imported. Of course, you need to ask for the personal, the doctor. Who will just come to the terminal to check the goods, to check the gases in the container. This kind of
But
thing.
that's a good topic for another for another short blog post or LinkedIn post. So we'll keep you updated on that and also like send you a link to the answer within the next days or weeks.
Great, really great that the guy is asking different questions from the technical to the law questions, so we can just figure it out what can we speak about later on next time.
Definitely. Thank you very much for the question. Thank you very much, Yetiris. When we first talked about the webinar, it was of course about the future development, and I think it was no accident that we choose reefer containers as the first topic because the future market development or the demand in general is supposed to grow over the next years and has already grown by a lot in the last few years. So people expect the demand for reefers and actually the market cap for reefers to grow by a CAGR of 5% over a year. That's like a the CAGR stands for accumulated annual growth rate, so 5% per year. And the key driving factors for the reefer market to grow and why it is interesting and why it is good to know about reefer containers is that we currently have an increasing demand for frozen and chilled commodities. I think, as the slide says, and it has mainly to do with the growing population in Asia. I think pretty much only in Asia at the moment. Income goes up, of course, and that actually more of those consumers want access and want to buy those products wherever they are. And yeah, so I'm not sure if you if from your experience, Alex, you can add
Yeah,
something here.
as I heard, I spoke with different suppliers that indeed leasing companies starting to they put the focus on the reefer market because there is much and much more food in the world, and that's why the reefers are much more popular in these days, and they are also they are like in the cars, the BMW from the 2010. It's totally different from nowadays. So the same with the reefer. And of course it's a growing market. It's very popular for the investors, for the leasing companies, and there will be definitely much more and more reefers on our market. Sure.
Yeah, especially in contrast to general market development in container logistics, this is a good field to invest in and to focus on, I think.
Yeah, definitely, because also the local customers who is buying the reefer containers to store their goods for the markets or for the the guys who is dealing with meat or food, they're buying much more, and they already know the specific what kind of reefer they want, sizes, etc. So it will be only growing. Definitely.
Maybe what just came into my mind before we're done with this webinar, maybe you can share one or two stories about how people use reefer containers after their sea transport life. Do they use reefers for events, or what were like good use cases you came across in the past?
Yeah, definitely, because it was actually the case that the guy a few weeks ago brought a reefer from us in Vita to store their plants. Yeah, they have plants, some things to add to the food, and they have a small factory outside of city. So they brought the reefer just to store it, and afterwards, when they have the orders from the market, they simply from their own storage, from their own fridge, they are taking the plants and went to the market. Also, the funny story was when was the championship. Football in Russia. The guys who is dealing with the organization of the football brought 5 reefer containers 4 feet to store the cold beer in it. So yeah, you see, so there is actually lots of new figures, new ideas how to use reefers more and more.
Maybe just as a general note, of course you can also use or supply reefer containers on exchange. We introduced reefer containers roughly 9 to 12 months ago, and so almost 1 year. So there's already like good liquidity almost everywhere for reefer containers. If you're interested in that, just send me an email or go to our website, and we do a free search for you, of course, to see if you've got containers where you need them. And also I will put Alex in CC and share his contact details with you if you have more questions about reefer containers that Alex could probably answer.
Sure.
Get in touch with him also, if you've got if you want to network, or if you're interested in any other topics that we should focus on, always reach out to us. Thank you very much for attending from my side. Hope you enjoyed this first general overview of reefer containers and